Visit also comes at a historic time in our relations. We are celebrating the 60th anniversary of the establishment of our diplomatic relations. And Excellency, your personal attention and leadership have contributed much to the steady direction, strength and vibrancy in our ties. Your contributions have been instrumental in forging a wide-ranging strategic partnership with India. Friends, our links with Malaysia have been civilizational and historical. Our relationship is rich and diverse. Our societies bond at many levels. Ties of cultural and religion provide a strong connect between our people. The contributions of a large Indian community in Malaysia are of a special value. They have not only nurtured our shared heritage, they have also been a strong driver of economy and people-to-people connectivity between our two countries. Prime Minister Majid and I have jointly celebrated the Toran Gate in Kuala Lumpur during my last visit. Modeled on the Toran Gate of the Sanchi Stupa, this stands as a symbolic of our abiding friendship. Friends, in our extensive conversation today, Prime Minister Najib and I took stock of the full range of our cultural, economic, and strategic engagement. We took note of the steady progress in implementation of key decisions taken by us during my visit to Malaysia in November 2015. And we agreed on a shared vision to enhance our strategic partnership. A vision that prioritizes an action-oriented approach. In this effort, deepening the existing areas of cooperation and charting new territory of engagement are among our key objectives. Friends, India and Malaysia are built a thriving economic partnership. In our efforts to scale this up as the fastest growing large economy in the world, India offers unparalleled opportunities. And to build new avenues of prosperity in our societies, we are ready to expand trade and capital flows between our two economies. Infrastructure has been an area of fruitful partnerships between us. necessity means, and your ambitious vision of developing smart cities match well with the Malaysian capacities. Malaysian companies are participating in many of our infrastructure projects across different states in India. Indian companies too are extensively engaged and invested in the Malaysian economy. We are pleased that a high level business delegation is accompanying our strategy and confident that the business partnership that they force will enhance the level and momentum of our commercial engagement. We are also converging efforts aimed at food security that are linked to the well-being of our farmers. The MOU and proposed development of a fertilizer plant in Malaysia and uptake of surplus urea from Malaysia to India is a welcome development. Friends, the UPAR University of Malaysia has started Ayurveda degree courses in Malaysia for the first time. This is a welcome development. And an Ayurveda chair in the same university is in the pipeline. Its early finalization would further cement our cooperation in this space. Our educational exchanges have always been a strong promoter of people-to-people ties between our countries. The signing today of the MOU on mutual recognition of degrees is a landmark development that will benefit the students and societies of both our countries. Friends, we live in a time and in a region where both conventional and non-conventional security threats are constantly on the rise. Professor Najib and I agree that this challenge threatens the stability and economic prosperity of our countries and the region. And require us and other countries of the region to work together. In this context, I deeply appreciate our continued cooperation with the Malaysian government in our joint anti-terrorism efforts. Excellency, your own leadership in countering radicalization and terrorism is an inspiration for the entire region. Our wide-ranging defense partnership has already brought our armed forces closer. We are cooperating in training and capacity building, maintenance of equipment and military hardware, maritime security, and in disaster response. Prime Minister Najib and I are also conscious of our role and responsibility in promoting economic prosperity, freedom of navigation, and stability in the Asia-Pacific area, especially its oceans. To secure our societies and for the greater regional good, we have agreed to further strengthen our strategic partnership to shape an effective response to our common concerns and challenges. As I said, Prime Minister, let me welcome you once again to India. I thank you for very productive decisions. I'm confident that our decisions today will drive our strategic partnership to the next level. I wish you an enjoyable and fruitful state in your life.